Hello everybody, myself Professor Pallavi Kule. So today we are going to see about the unfruitfulness. Introduction. Unfruitfulness is a major problem in many fruit crops and their varieties, results in a huge loss to the growers and make the fruit cultivation less profitable. Fruitfulness refers to the state where the plant is not only capable of flowering and bearing the fruit but also takes these fruits to maturity. The inability to do so is known as unfruitfulness or the barrenness. In spite of the adequate flowering, low fruit yield in the orchard have been experienced because of the low initial fruit set and subsequently higher fruit late abscission. Problems of unfruitfulness. In an orchard, all the fruit trees do not bear equally or regularly and sometimes fail to flower and fruit under a similar condition where another fruit tree bears heavily. This failure to set the fruits may be attributed to unfruitfulness. To understand the problem of unfruitfulness in the orchard, a familiarity with the following terms is necessary. The following terms are fruit setting. It refers to initial growth of the ovary and its associated parts after blooming and taking it to maturity. Fruitfulness. It is the state of the plant when it is not only capable of flowering and fruit setting but also takes this fruit to maturity. An inability to do so is unfruitfulness or barrenness. Infertility. Ability of the plant not only to produce the fruits but develop a viable seeds. And the inability to do so is referred to as the sterility or infertility. All the fertile plants are fruitful, but all the fruitful plants are not fertile. Self-unfruitfulness. Ability of the plant to mature fruits after self-pollination. Self-sterility. Capacity of a plant for the production of the viable seeds after self-pollination. The ability of the plant to produce the optimum crop is fruitfulness. Whereas the inability to achieve this is referred to as unfruitfulness. Causes of problem. Internal factors, external factors. Internal factors associated with unfruitfulness. Evolutionary tendencies, genetic influences and physiological factors. Evolutionary tendencies. Monoecious and dioecious nature. Heterostyly, dichogamy. Abortive flowers or the aborted pistil or ovule. Importance of the pollen. Monoecious and dioecious nature of the plant. A plant with stamens and the carpel in the different flowers on the same plant is monoecious. For example, coconut, arachnut, pecan nut, capri fig and hazel. In the monoecious fruit plant, in general, there is no or a very little problem of pollination, fruit setting and fruitfulness. Nevertheless, pollinators need to be ensured. Plants which bear male and female flowers on the different plants are known as dioecious, papaya, date palm and strawberry. Likewise, a few varieties of the plum produces too little pollen to call them bisexual. Profuse flowering without the fruit set in ornamental pomegranate is a result of their being unisexual. A number of sex forms have been reported in the papaya by the different scientists. In the case of the fig, two types of the flower clusters are born, namely staminated and the pistillated flowers. In capri fig, staminated flowers are born near the eye and the pistillated flowers are born near the end. To ensure the good fruit set, retention of a new stamen trees is essential as a pollinizer. Heterostyly, a condition in the flowers where the length of the style relative to the other parts of the flower differ in the flowers of the different plants. In this case, in some flowers, styles are short with a long filament, and in some of flowers of same species or the variety, styles are long with a short filament. The styles and stigmas at different height prevent self-pollination. In case of brinjal, there are the four types of the flowers according to their length of style: long, medium, pseudo short and the true short. Out of this, pseudo short and the true short do not produce any fruit. Similarly, in the delicious group of the apples, extreme upright position of the stamens accompanied by Spreaded petals do not ferment bees to do the pollination while collecting the nectar. When the pistils of the heterostyle plants are pollinated with the pollen from the same flowers or from the other flowers containing stamens of an equal height, the union may be fruitful, but it is likely to be a varying degree of sterility. Here the arrangements for the cross-pollination needs to be created. Dichogamy. When the stigmatic receptivity period does not coincide with the pollen viability in the monoecious plant, it is known as the dichogamy. In the dichogamy, self-pollination is prevented in the perfect flowered plants. Due to the maturity of the two sex elements at the different times, if the stamen ripe before the stigma becomes receptive, the flower is known as the protandrous, and if the stigma becomes receptive before the stamen produces the viable pollen, it is known as the protogynous. This results in the low production of the fruits. Protogyny is present in the monoecious plants like walnut, hazelnut, etc., whereas a protandry is present in the many coconut varieties. Majority of the dioecious plants are also the protogynous. Abortive flowers or the aborted pistils or the ovules. This occurs in the developing flower pistils and the stigmas of the many species and is responsible for the failure in the fruit setting. Abortion of the partially developed flower buds is common. Setting and the maturity of the two sexes depends on the erosion of two properly formed sex cells. By any interference with their development and the functioning may lead to the sterility or unfruitfulness. Such things can be observed in some grape varieties and the tomato varieties. The red flowers of the strawberry clusters are also abortive. This is more common and in the indeterminate type of plants. Degeneration of the pistils takes the forms of the abortion, and it is more common in the ornamental pomegranate. Certain olive varieties have attained to 60% of the abortive embryos. It is also common in the some of the apple varieties. Embryos at abortion becomes a cause of seedlessness in the certain instance than the fruitfulness. Next is the importance of the pollen. Many varieties of the grapes produces the non-viable or the important pollens, though they appear as the perfect flowers. Sterility in the grape variety was the result of the important pollens. Sterile pollen in the grape results from the degeneration processes in the generative nucleus or the arrested development prior to the mitosis in the microspore nucleus. This ID also common in JHL peach, Washington navel, orange and a Tahiti lime. Genetic influences. Self-sterility is a condition determined by the inheritance received but can develop in a favorable environment. Self-sterility affects its offspring as well as hybrids. Sterility and unfruitfulness due to the hybridity and incompatibility. Generally, the wider the crossing, greater is the degree of the sterility encountered. The cross between the peach and the plum bears abundance of the flowers, but they are without the pistils with deformed stamens. Flower characteristics are the constant, sterile and barren. A hybrid between the pear and the quince was seedless. Most of the citragine cross between sweet orange and the citrus trifoliata produce a no fertile female gametes. Seedlessness is the most of the banana and the pineapple varieties is due to the hybrid nature of their ancestors. Most of the triploid apple varieties produces the aborted pollen. A number of the hybrids between Vitis rodentifolia and the Vitis are the completely sterile. Similar was the case with the hybridization of the Vitis vinifera and the Vitis rodentifolia. Incompatibility. One of the most common causes of the self-unfruitfulness and the self-sterility is due to the incompatibility between the pollen and the ovules of the same plant or the same variety. Pollen and the ovules are fertile, but they fail to affect conjunction. In apple, pear, plum and unla, self-incompatibility varieties requires another pollinizer varieties for fruit setting. Self-incompatibility has been reported in some of the mango varieties, that is Langra, the Sherry and Chausam. Self-sterility and self-unfruitfulness has been reported in apple, pear, plums, almond, apricot, and the clematis mandarins may be attributed to the incompatibility where the normal processes of fertilization fails somewhere between the production of the functional gametes and the fusion of the sex cells. Physiological influences, slow pollen tube growth, premature or the delayed pollination, nutritive condition of the plant, effect of the pollen variety, viability, effect on the defectiveness of the pistils, fruit setting of the flowers in different position. Slow pollen tube growth. Slow growth of the pollen tube results in the unfruitfulness. Differences have been found in the rate of the growth in the self and across apples, pear, cherries and the certain citrus fruits. This may be considered one type of the incompatibility due to the chemotropic or the hormone influences. Besides this, fertilization should take place within a short time, failing which abscission will take place at the base of the style, ovary, pedicel and the peduncle, and the fruit setting does not take place. Premature or the delayed pollination. Premature or the delayed pollination leads to unfruitfulness. Tobacco flowers are very susceptible to the injury from a premature pollination. When the mature pollen grains are applied to the immature pistils, they germinate, penetrate the style, enters the ovule, and if the ovules are not ready for the fertilization, the flowers will fall. However, in the case of the oranges, premature pollination did not have any deleterious effect, whereas some injury was noticed in tomato. Lower setting due to the premature pollination was noticed in the persimmon, pear, plum and peach. Similarly, if the pollination is delayed, the flower fall without setting. Delay in the pollination for 2 to 3 days did not affect the fruit set. However, further delaying may result into the polyembryonic seeds in some species. Nutritive conditions of the plant. Nutritive conditions of the plant just before or at or just after the time of the blossoming is an important factor determining the percentage of the flowers caring for setting and for maturity. It may affect the pollen viability or the fertility of the pistils. Effect of pollen viability. There was a significant difference in the germination percentage of the pollen collected from the old apple trees and from a strong young trees of same variety. Effect on the defectiveness of pistil. Exertion of the tree by overbearing drought or the poverty of the soil leads to the production of the defective pistils. Overbearing weakens the fruit trees and in coming season production is adversely affected. Close correlations was reported between defective pistils and the unfruitfulness in the American plums. In the case of the Vitis vinifera, carbohydrate deficiency is the common cause of the flower drop. Due to the carbohydrate deficiency, flower abortion and ultimately unfruitfulness also occurs in the greenhouse grown tomatoes. Fruit setting of the flowers in the different position. Fruits born on the terminal growth have a more competition in many fruit crops and the mature and set under a normal nutritional conditions, but the percentage of the set is small. This positional competition takes place between the fruits and the branches as well as between the different fruit influencing fruitfulness. Strong and the weak spurs. Nutritional condition of the spurs have a positive correlation with the fruit setting in apple. Spurs on the vigorous limbs with a large leaf set more fruits than those born on the weak limbs. More flowers ultimately lead to the more fruit set, and the more flowers are generally born on the strong limbs. Likewise, the flowers born singly sets the fruits and matures as the fruit and maturity, and majority of those born in the cluster drop down. Ringing or the whirling also leads to the accumulation of an extra store of the food material, leads to the fruit set and develop parthenocarpically. In the process of fructification, the embryo is more important for development. That is, if the nutritive condition is favorable, it accomplishes the development of the seeds, coat and fruit wall. If not, only the latter portions are in the high degree, retardation is development. Under the insufficient nutrient supply, the numbers of the seeds forming the ovules are diminished, and under the extreme nutrition deficiency, both a fruit wall and a large number of the ovules are diminished, leading to the enabling to form the seeds. In the case of the greenhouse cucumbers, nutritional deficiency leads to the arrest of the growth of growing fruits depending upon the position of the fruits and the time of pollination. If a few of the cucumbers are harvested, remaining fruits resumes growth. In the case of the strawberries, producing the bisexual flowers may lead to produce the pistillated flowers if the nutritional deficiency was observed. However, nutritive conditions has indirect influence on the compatibility. Unfruitfulness associated with the external factors, nutrient supply, pruning and training, locality, season, temperature, light, pest and diseases. Nutrient supply, in certain families like Gramineae, Cruciferae and Leguminaceae, sterility normally occurs due to the overfeeding. If the sterile is rich, soil becomes itself fertile in a poor soil. High fertility level is generally associated with a good pistil development and a low level with a poor pistils and good stamens and grapes. In the olives, low fertility leads to the partial or the complete degeneration of the pistils. Pruning and training. Pruning tends to produce a more true hermaphrodite conditions in a grape variety hoe. If the pruning is not done, the variety tends to remain sterile and produces separated pistils. Locality. Jonathan apple, which is sterile in one location, is reported to be a self fertile in another location. Season. Hybrid grape ideal is a self impotent early in the season but becomes self potent later on. Temperature. High temperature at the flowering dries up the stigmatic secretion and prevents the pollination. Tomato varieties grown at a high temperature do not produce any fruits. Light. Exposure of the strawberry plant to the long photo period results in the development of the stamens and the pistils in the strawberry flowers. Pest and diseases. Mango hopper, powdery mildew, etc. adversely affect the fruit set and development in mango and grapes. Spraying of the trees when they are in a bloom. Spraying at the flowering reduces the fruit set. Some of the fungicides have inhibitory effect on the pollen grains. Copper fungicides at 200 to 10,000 ppm prevent the germination of the pollen grains on the stigma. Steps to overcome the problems of unfruitfulness. Having the known that there would be many reasons for unfruitfulness, it is necessary to make the necessary corrective measures, which should begin from the planning level and extend to an established orchard. Choice of the crop and the variety should be made on the basis of the climate and the edaphic conditions of the site of the orchardy. Provision of the windbreak and shelter belts for the areas prone to wind damage. Before planting an orchard, soil should be brought to the optimity by incorporating organic manure, amendments and the nutrients based on the soil analysis. In case of the problems of pollination due to heterostyle, dichogamy, incompatibility, sterility, embryo abortion, hybridity, etc., a mixture of the varieties should be grown by introduction, effective pollinizer varieties and the pollinators. Unfruitfulness due to the slow growth of the pollen tube, immature and the delayed pollination, use of the plant growth regulators can be affected after the standardization in the terms of the chemical concentration and the timing application. The problem due to the old age could be overcoming by the replanting or the rejuvenation of the old trees. Problem due to the overbearing can be managed through thinning at appropriate stage. Irrigation management should be key role in the situation with a drought and overloading conditions. Waterlogging conditions. Problem due to the uneven distribution of the flowers on the trees should be managed through thinning and crop regulation. Maintenance of the critical nutrient status in the tree leaves for the optimum crop production by adopting the corrective nutritional program based on the plant and soil analysis. In the crop requiring a regular pruning, standard practices will have to be adopted based on the crop variety and its phenology. Unfruitfulness due to the pathogen should be managed through the effective plant protection measures following integrated approaches. Problems of unfruitfulness due to the tendency of alternative bearing should be overcome through the replacement of the regular bearing varieties and crop regulation. Conclusion. Unfruitfulness can be due to the lack of the balance between the growth and the fruiting and the lack of the flowering and a poor fruit set as a result of the various internal and external factors in the different fruits and their cultivars. So it is necessary to make the necessary corrective measures which should begin from the planting level and extend to an establishment of the orchard. So it is important to analyze the problems and then corrective measures could be suggested. Basically, planning should be done so that the further will be problem-free. And then adoption of the corrective packages of the practices should be followed. Thank you. This was all about the unfruitfulness.